Can you shed some more light on what overconfidence results in the financial market?
So broadly, it is high concentration, high trading volumes, and to some extent, over leverage. People take up leverage when they are overconfident about a position. So these three things lead to poor portfolio results for an investor.
Okay.
Overconfidence affects every aspect of investment decision making. It affects stock picking also. At the same time, it affects the market timing for an investor.
When you say stock picking and portfolio construction, can you give us a little bit more details on that?
So I'll take you through another small experiment that we went through as a, in a behavioral finance class. So I'd taken a class with Hirsch Sheffrin, and he's a very renowned behavioral finance specialist. So he made the class do an exercise where we are supposed to ask answer certain questions.
Right.
And it was okay if you didn't get the number or that data right. You had to give a range of data or range of an answer where we are confident that 90% of the, with 90% probability that we'll be right. So in a 10 question paper, we would be right at least nine. So we have to give that kind of a range. Now, to sample the questions were, there would be a question about what is the diameter of the moon or which year was King Ashoka born. So you had to give a range because you may not know the exact number, you gave a range. Most of us made a mistake that we kept the range too narrow.
Okay.
Even if it was a data that we were not knowing, we kept the range narrow and the average accuracy was about 65% in the class, which was, I think, what historically the professor had with his other classes also. But we were targeting 90.
Okay.
Now, why did we keep the range too narrow? Most of the time, we are very overconfident even about the guesses that we are taking. We keep them quite tight and narrow. And when questions are complex, even then, we want to keep a very tight range. So let's take in financial market stock picking, when we are forecasting a company's intrinsic value. We have to forecast, say, revenue growth, the profit growth, the cash flows of a company, what rate to discount it at. We then, if we are doing a comparative valuation, we have to decide which comparative valuation method to take. What is the range of valuations we will take? Now, after doing all that, we still come to one target price. Now, that's something that shows overconfidence, right? That you are ultimately saying that the company or the intrinsic value is one number. Even Benjamin Graham and David Dodd, when they wrote the book Security Analysis, they wrote that intrinsic value cannot be as determinable as market price of a company. It has to be a range of outcomes. And most people keep these ranges too tight. And while you can go wrong if you are calculating only one intrinsic value, even if you are vaguely right about that number, people who put only one target price or one number to a intrinsic value, they tend to then have overconfidence of trading around that number.
Okay.
And in many of these trades, they may either make a loss or miss out on a good opportunity because of that overconfidence.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risk. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.